Stanford University.
Probably. Right now we're at really high likelihood, 90% likelihood, that El Nino will persist not only into the winter, but then also high likelihood that it'll persist into the spring.
El Nino is fundamentally an oceanic phenomenon where the equatorial eastern Pacific Ocean warms above its normal temperature. And the effect that has on the atmosphere above is pretty substantial. Both hemispheres experience these large changes in prevailing weather patterns as a result of these ocean temperature anomalies in the tropical Pacific.
One prediction is that, you know, because we have really strong El Nino conditions in the tropics and really warm waters between the tropics and California, this coming rainy season could be really, really wet, because as those storms make their way across the Pacific, they're going to pick up that moisture from the warm ocean water. The opposing prediction is that because we have all this warm ocean water outside of the tropics, that that's contributing to the ridging in the atmosphere that will tend to block the storms. What's different about this particular El Nino year is we're starting out from a position of extreme drought. This is the most extreme drought in California's recorded history. What that means is that soils are really dry. It means we've seen a lot of tree death. We're having wildfires that are burning a lot of forests. And all of those conditions on the surface make for greater potential of flooding and greater potential of problems with excess water.
On the one hand, water in any form will help a lot with some of the short-term and acute impacts with the fire danger and the acute water shortages. But for real long-term relief, what we need to see are several consecutive wet years and several consecutive years where our snowpack persists into the spring and summer months, so that can slowly replenish our groundwater aquifers and provide this long-term relief from this multi-year drought that we've been experiencing.
We know that this drought is going to end at some point. If we get a strong El Nino and a lot of storms this winter, that'll hasten the ending of the drought. But we do know that we're in a new climate, and managing drought in California, the risks of drought, the impacts of drought, that's more than just getting through this one drought. And that's because we know that California has warmed. We know that that warming of California has increase the conditions that create drought. In our research, we find it's about twice as likely to produce drought. So even after this drought ends, we're still going to be in a situation where we're more likely to get the next drought the next time that we have low rainfall.
It was more rebounded.
It was on the linear negative trend.
Yes, exactly.
For more, please visit us at stanford.edu.